Hello dear students, a very warm good morning to all of you. So we are discussing our lesson, that is what? Crop production and management. In that we have discussing about irrigation. Already we have discussed about the irrigation. Also we have discussed about the what are the sources of irrigation. So today we'll move for the next point from the same point, that is what? Traditional methods of irrigation. So today we'll discuss about the which are the methods for the irrigation. Among that, we'll discuss first that are traditional methods of irrigation. So, which are the traditional methods of the irrigation that we will discuss? So, in the traditional method, there were used of the cattle as well as the labors. Okay, or the human labor work is more. Cattle are also used to irrigate the plant or the crops, or also we can say the human or the laborers work is more in the traditional method. Okay. So, cattle or human labor is used in this method, in the traditional method, okay. So, there are the different traditional method we will see, which are that, like that we can say that mode, chain, pump, bhekti and rahut, okay. So, all these four methods you can see in the image how it exactly it was, okay. So, these are the traditional methods of the irrigation, that is what? Mode, chain, pump, bhekti and rahut, okay. So these were the traditional method. Then why the people leave it, or why the people nowadays it is not using it? Because these methods are cheaper but less efficient. Okay. So these methods were cheaper. Means we have to not give the more amount, or it will not cost more money, but it is not that much efficient. Okay. So irrigation means what? We have to provide the water at a regular interval, but with the help of that is what? We have to control the wastage of water also, okay. So for that reason these traditional methods were not that much efficient, okay. So now we will discuss about the modern methods of irrigations, okay. So which are the modern methods of the irrigation? There are the basically two main types of the modern methods of the irrigation, that are what? Sprinkler system and a drip system, okay. So one by one we will discuss. First we will go through the sprinkler system, okay. So the sprinkler system means what? So the sprinkler system useful on the uneven land where is the availability of the water is what? Less. So the sprinkler system mainly used in the area where the land is what? Uneven, or there is no plain land where there is an uneven land, and also we can say that there is a less availability of the water in that region, the sprinkler air system of the water or the watering plant is used. Okay. Next one is that perpendicular pipe having the rotating nozzle on it. So in the image you can see how it is exactly sprinkler system. Okay. So the sprinkler system is having one perpendicular pipe to the land. So there is one pipe which is perpendicular to the land, and on the top of that perpendicular pipe there is a one rotating nozzle which are having the holes. Okay. That is only we are calling as what? Nozzle, and that nozzle is what? Rotating. Okay. So on the perpendicular pipe there is having a rotating nozzle on the top. So whenever the water is going in the main pipe, or whenever the water is flowing at the from the main pipe at the regular interval of the time under the high pressure, then what happens? With the help of these nozzles the water is escaped, okay, or the water is coming out with the help of these nozzles. Okay. So whenever the water is flowing with the high pressure in the main pipe, with the help of the rotating nozzle the water is escaped, or we can say the water is comes out from the nozzle, okay, and it almost looks like a rain or a gradient sprinkle over the crops. Okay. So it mainly useful for the sandy soil. This sprinkler system is mainly useful for the sandy soil, okay, and it sprinkle on the crop like the rain. But in the sprinkler irrigation what happened? Sprinkler irrigation system is useful in the sandy soil, or we can say the water, or the in the area where there is a not sufficient water, or we can say that where it is a not available, there is not that much amount of the water, there is a scarcity of the water, we can say that. But with the help of the sprinkler irrigation what happens? The water reaches to the parts of a plant, okay, where it is not exactly required, okay. Where is the water required in the plant? It should go into the soil, and from the soil the roots can absorb that water. But in the sprinkle irrigation, what happens? With the help of the roots, the water is also gets sprinkled through the whole plant, where it is not that much necessary. Okay, so with the help of the sprinkle irrigation, we can sprinkle or we can irrigate the crops, but there are the certain demerits for the sprinkle irrigation also. Okay, that is demerit is what? So that more amount of the water is getting wasted, or the more amount of the water is getting we are doing the irrigation to the parts of a plant where it is not required, or there is a not requirement for the water, or in that area there is not requirement of the water. Where is the exactly water necessary? In the roots. Or how the roots will get absorb the water? Whenever the water will goes into the soil. So for that there is a next method which is very efficient, that is what? Drip irrigation, or we can say that drip system. So in the drip system, what happens? The water falls drop by drop just at the position of the root. Okay, so in the image you can see that where is the exactly water falls during, by using the drip irrigation. What happens? The drop by drop water is get falls just at the position of the root. Okay, so in this way, what happens? The water will get in that portion only where there is a necessity of the water. Okay, also next one you can say that best for watering fruits, plants, gardens and trees. So this drip irrigation is useful for the fruit, plants, gardens and the trees. So this technique is most useful for the watering fruit, plants, gardens and the trees. And in this drip irrigation, there is no wastage of the water. The water is not getting wasted. How the water is not getting wasted? Because as we know, as you can see in the image also, the drop by drop water is fall just at the position of the roots. Okay, where it is exactly necessary, or where it is exactly necessity of the water. Okay. Next one is that, and this drip irrigation system is born in a region where the availability of the water is. And this drip irrigation is the very important technique, or the very important techniques in the region where there is a scarcity of the water, or we can say there is a where the availability of the water is poor, or in short we can say that in the areas where there is a scarcity of the water. Okay, so these are the two main modern methods of the irrigation, that are what? Sprinkle system and the drip system. So this is all about irrigation. Now we will move for the next point, that is what? Crop protection. Okay, so let's start the next point, that is what? Protection from weeds. Okay, so as the crop is growing, or with the help of the crops, there are the certain plants also growing which are undesirable, or which are not good for the us, or we are not using it. Okay, that is what? Useless plants are also growing with the crop, and that is undesirable plants are only called as what? Weeds. Okay, so the undesirable plants are called weeds. So these weeds are also growing with the crops, because see, as we are providing the proper manure, fertilizer, also we are giving the proper irrigation, then the crops are growing very nicely. But along with the crops, all these things are also getting to the weeds. So the weeds are also growing with the crops. Okay, so today we'll discuss that how we can protect the crop from the weed. That is the next agriculture practice, what? Protection from weeds. So the undesirable plants are called weeds. So why we have to remove these weeds, or why we have to protect the plant from the weeds, that we will discuss. Okay, let's see. Weeds harm crops in the following ways. In which way the weeds are harms to the plants? Okay, let's see. They consume a great amount of nutrients, water, sunlight and space. Okay, so the weeds can use it, or the weeds can consume a great amount of what? Nutrients, water and sunlight, and also the space which are required for the crop, or which is necessary for the crop. Okay, so with the help of the weeds, the crops can share the space. So in this way, what happens if the weeds can grow with the help of the crops, then what happens? The crops will not get the proper amount of the water, nutrients, or also we can say that what space and also the sunlight. Okay, and it will affect the quality of the crops, and that is the reason we have to remove the weeds from the field. Okay, so the weeds consume a great amount of nutrient, water, sunlight, and space. Okay, next one, interfere even in harvesting. Okay, so sometimes what happens, it get interfere, it make a obstacles during the process of what, harvesting. So some weeds are interferes even in harvesting. There are the certain weeds which produce some toxic substances. Okay, so there are the some weeds which produce the toxic substances which are harmful, or it may be poisonous for animals and human beings. Okay, so because of all these reasons, the farmer should remove the weeds from the fields. Okay, or remove the weeds from the crops. Okay, so these are the certain reasons. For that reason, the farmer should remove the weeds from the crops. So how to remove that, which techniques, which method we have to use to remove the weeds from the crop, that we will discuss now. Okay, so that is what, the process of removing of weed from a crop is called as what, weeding. Okay, so the farmer, because of all these reasons, the farmer is removing the weed from the crop, and that process of what, or the removing of the weed from the crop is called as what, weeding. The process of removing the weeds from a crop is called weeding. Okay, so there are the certain methods that farmer is using to remove the weeds. Let's discuss that method one by one. First one, we will discuss about the mechanical method. So from the name only we can understand that mechanical method is what, some instruments we are using to do that. Okay, let's see. So the weeds can pull down with hand or through plowing. Okay, so in the plowing or the tilling, we have seen that why we have to make a tilling of the soil, because the tilling or the plowing helps the farmer to remove the weeds from the soil. Okay, so with the help of the hand, we can pull out the weeds. Okay, so weeds pulled out with hand or through plowing. We can pull out the weeds with the help of the hands or with the help of the plowing agriculture practice. Okay, next one, it can also be removed by seed drill. Okay, tractor driven seed drill. Okay, we can remove the weeds by tractor driven seed drill, hoe or harrow. Okay, so all these instruments we can use to remove the weeds from the field. Okay, next one, it can be removed manually by using a trowel. Okay, so it can remove manually, means the laborers or the farmers can also remove it by using the one type of the instrument, that is what, trowel. Okay, so all these are what, the agriculture implements that the farmers are using to remove the weeds from the field or weeds from the crops. Okay, so this is about the first method, that is what, mechanical method. Now we'll discuss about what, chemical method. So the chemical, it means what, the farmers are using the certain types of the chemicals which kills the weeds. Okay, and that chemicals are called as what, weedicide. Okay, so the weed killing chemicals are called weedicide. So there are the certain chemicals which we spread on the crops, and that doesn't harm the crop, they only kill the weeds, and that chemicals are called as what, weedicide. Weed killing chemicals are called weedicide. Okay, so there are the main example of, there is a very common Indian example of the weedicide is what, 2,4-D, that is what, 2,4-dichlorophenoxyacetic acid. Okay, so this is the one example of the weedicide. So this weedicide doesn't harm any crop, or it doesn't harm to the crop, but it kills only weeds. Okay, but there is very important thing is that whenever the farmer is spraying the weedicide, you can see in the image how we can spread the weedicide, or how the farmer is spreading the weedicide. So whenever there is a spraying of the weedicide, the farmer should cover his mouth and the nose with a thick cloth properly, because this weedicide is what, poisonous, and it can harm the health of the farmers also. And if you are spraying the weedicide on the crop, then before using or before consuming the grains from the field, you should wash it very properly, because the weedicide is a very poisonous. Okay, so this is about what chemical method. Now we'll see the next method. Okay, so let's discuss the next method of the removing of the weed, that is what biological method. Okay, so let's see what happens in that. Insect or some other organisms that consume and specifically destroy the weed plants are introduced in the crop fields is called biological control of weeds. So in this method, what happened? Biological method. Then obviously, what will be happened? There will be some biotic components included in that. So what the farmers are doing? They are introducing certain types of the insects, okay, or some other organisms that specifically feeds on the weed only, and in this way they will destroy or they will remove all the weeds from the crop field, and that method is called as what? Biological control of weeds. Okay, so insects or some other organisms that consume and specifically destroy the weeds plant are introduced in the crop field is called biological control of weeds. Okay, and very common example of the very common Indian biological method or the Indian example for the biological control of the weed cycle is weed is what? Prickly pear cactus. So that is what? Prickly pear cactus is a very well known example for the biological method to control of weeds. Okay, next one we discuss about the next method, that is protection from pests and diseases. Okay, so this is the next method. We have to protect the plants from the pests and the diseases also. Okay, so what is meant by the pest? So pest is an organism which kills or which destroy the crops. Okay, these are the certain organisms that attack and damage the crops. So to avoid it, to protect the plant from these things, the farmers are using the different types of the pesticides. Okay, the farmers are using the different types of the pesticides. So there are the so many types of the pesticides are there. So many pests are there, like that rodents are there. Also we can say that some insects are there and many more are there. Or to kill that, the farmers are using the certain pesticide which kill all these insects. Okay, so to kill the rodents, the farmers are using certain rodenticides. Okay, by using this chemical, the rodent will get killed. So it is called as what? Rodenticide. And to kill certain insects, the farmers are using what? Insecticides. Okay, so in this way, these are the two types of the pesticide, that are what? Rodenticides and the insecticide. Okay, but this rodenticide and the insecticide we have to use in a very less amount. Okay, and we have to spray it by using the hand machine or the hand sprayer. And if the area of the crop is large, then we have to use the low laying aircraft. Okay, and very important thing is that all these pesticides or all these chemicals, whatever we are using, that farmers should use in a very less quantity, because all these are the very poisonous for the human beings. Okay, so if the farmers are using the more amount of this pesticide, then with the help of the water, or this pesticide will get mixed into the water, and that water will get absorbed by the plant. Okay, and if we eat the fruits or the other grains from that same plant, then it will get affects to our body, or it will harms our body, because the pesticides are so much poisonous for the human beings and for the other animals also. Okay, so this is all about today. We have discussed about the methods of irrigation, and also we have discussed about the protection of weed, and also we have discussed which are the methods that we have to use to kill the weeds. Okay, so this is all about today. It is the time to tell you goodbye. We will meet in the next video. For today, thank you.